Hey, everybody. It won't be long until Christmas. And I was going to try to get another video uploaded before Christmas. I have these two Sharpie permanent markers. Purposely chose red and green because of Christmas. I want to make sure that they work. Yes, I'm convinced that they work. So this catalog came to my mailbox. Have not received near as many catalogs this year as years gone by. Really not sure why that is, but it is what it is. So, Sharper Image Santa's Secret. So this video, as you may have guessed, is going to be a this or that. If you're new to my channel and have never seen this or that video, basically I'm going to choose an item from each page that if I had to choose something from each page, I'll circle it. You can kind of play along to see if you guess the same thing that I choose. So I think what I'll do is one page constitutes everything that you see in the view. So I can choose something from this page or something from this page. So we start off with a USB stick that they call it a photo vault. It's 32 gig. And I guess it has some software on it that makes it easy to back up your photos from your computer. Here's a wireless headphones. And a personal massager. Ooh. And down here is virtual Pong. P-O-N-G. Looks like some kind of game. It's a fast-paced, futuristic game that keeps players on their toes with a simulated ball of light that bounces off the walls. Huh. Here's a cordless infrared therapy wrap. I guess it's basically a fancy word for a heating pad. Here's a heated ice scraper. A heated ice scraper. Oh, I see a flaw. Plugs into your car cigarette lighter to help you melt and clear stubborn ice and snow. Yes, you have to have your door open so that you can have the cord running all the way into your car. It'd be nice if it was battery operated. So if I had to choose something, oh, we forgot something. Here's a 8-in-1 emergency auto tool. Looks like it has a knife and emergency LED light and screwdrivers and stuff kind of built into it. So if I had to choose something on this page, in case you can't see this, let me give you a look at that. That's pretty cool. I think I'm going to take the photo vault. So, how many of you guessed the first round? Round number two. Golf ball finding glasses. It helps you easily find the golf balls with a pair of these. So when you're looking through these glasses, it looks like it darkens everything except the golf balls, which stand out. Here's a wide mouth duffel bag. I already have a couple of those, except they're black. Here's what they call a fat freezer. Chin and neck sculpting system. What's it do? Somehow it smooths and sculpts chins and necks. I don't know about that. Here's a what they call a TENS massager and remote control. The TENS. It's an acronym for transuchinous electrical nerve stimulation. It uses electrical impulses to block pain. Here's a rechargeable wine opener with foil cutter. Okay, and on this page is a laptop tray. So if you want to lay in bed, propped up in bed, or maybe on a couch or something, you can have this tray for your laptop. Because, you know, having a laptop actually in your lap and using it isn't... It's really not safe over time. I don't think you want something like a computer, you know, in your lap, touching your body while it's running. I don't think that would be safe. Here's a heated full body massage mat that you put it in your chair. And I guess it pulsates and heats up. It's like a vibrating heating pad. And here's some kind of game called a Monster Vision. I guess you shoot at them with a toy gun. So, out of all of this stuff, I don't know what to pick. The wine opener just seems like just another thing to take up space on a countertop. The little lap desk, I think, would be the most useful thing for me. Okay, round three. Here's some night vision binoculars. Boy, those are pretty neat. Here's a rolling tool stool. You can sit on it. It can also accommodate your tools. And it has some holders for screwdrivers and some drawers that come out. Here's a vertical practice net for practicing your chip shots for golf. You set that up in your backyard and see if you can get it into the pockets. Here's a sports team car door light. Attaches to the inside of your car door. And projects a genuine team logo onto the ground every time you open your door. Well, why? I don't know. It's a novelty for sure. Here's a smart fish finder. It's a sonar bobber that attaches to the end of your line. Cast it into the water, and within seconds, your phone displays where the fish are. Can you believe that? A bobber with a sonar and an app on your phone to show you where the fish are. Well, it seems like a regular bobber kind of shows you where the fish are too, because it bobs up and down. Maybe it tells you how deep the fish are so that you know how deep to set the line. I don't know. Here's a draft beer system. canned draft beer system uses ultrasonic vibrations to create a dense micro foam that boosts the flavor of any canned beer. Oh my gosh. Okay. Here's a 186 piece tool set. It's got this nice aluminum case. And here's some tape measures that have not only a analog metal blade scale, it's also got a digital readout. So that's kind of interesting. Now, I think the night vision binoculars are the clear choice. So what do we have here? Show your team pride with a hover helmet in a hover jersey. So that's just a cute little thing to put on your desk. I think it uses magnetism to kind of suspend these objects. You know, I guess it's each end is pulling on it with magnetism, so it can't go up and it can't go down. Yeah, pretty cool, I guess. Here's a cordless electronic putting green that you can roll out, put it into the hole, and it returns the ball to you. Here's a compact elliptical trainer. And a battery organizer. Boy, those things are still on the market. I don't know about you, but I just buy a pack of batteries and take a couple out as needed. Put the package back in the drawer, and when it's empty, I get another pack. Does anyone actually use? If you're watching this video and you use one of these battery organizers, let me know. I mean, you know, I'm kind of particular about certain things, like, you know, how my socks are lined up in a dresser drawer, that kind of thing. Never been too particular about my batteries. I mean, I have a battery drawer and I just got batteries in it, but they're not organized. They're just loose packs of batteries. Here's a beverage dispenser that you put in your golf bag, and it looks like a golf club, and you hold a cup under it and dispense the beverage. Didn't Rodney Dangerfield have one of these on that old golf movie? What was it called? Caddyshack. Here's a nose hair trimmer. if you buy someone one of those for Christmas, be careful. They might think that you're trying to tell them something. Here's a box guitar made out of a cigar box. I think my son built one of those one time. And here's a cordless golf club cleaner. Quickly cleans, irons. See, that's just another battery-operated gadget. You know, what's wrong with just getting a hand brush and just brushing them yourself? I mean, there's the club face. There's the person's hand. I mean, you got your hand down there next to the club anyhow. Just take a brush and you don't have to have a battery operated gizmo. but understand people invent things and they want to sell them. There's certainly nothing wrong with that whatsoever. Here's a light and massage therapy hairbrush. A therapy hairbrush. Massage therapy hairbrush. So, even the hairbrushes have batteries in them. Gee whiz. Here's a self haircut device. And a number one rated shower mirror. Okay. And looks like a beard trimmer. And what's this? Cordless bald head shaver. So you can shave your head bald with that, if that's what you want to do. And here's a electric razor. Electric shaver. And a fat burning belt. And yeah. Electronic muscle stimulation. Make the fat melt right off of your stomach. And here's another cordless trimmer. So I think if I was gonna buy something from these pages, what do you think I would buy? It would have to be pretty useful for me. And the thing about this mirror, it hooks up, water goes through this, and it hooks into the plumbing of the shower head. And the hot water goes into the mirror and keeps the mirror from fogging up. Now that, my friends, would be very, very useful. Excellent. I've never seen one. I sure would like to have one. It's $140 in this catalog. Quite honestly, I did not know these existed. Here's gifts for her. There is a timeless rose mounted underneath a glass dome. That's pretty. And here's a gift to help remove stubborn belly fat. I don't know if that's something I would give as a gift. Let's see, unless they specifically asked unless they specifically asked for that, you know, if they ask for it, that's fine. Buy it for them. But if they didn't ask for it, do not buy a gift like that for, well, I was going to say for a woman, but even for a man, just don't do it. Trust me on that. Here's gloves for in socks. I guess they got lotion. Yeah. I guess you put lotion on them and put them on your hands at bedtime. Wake up with some nice soft feet, soft hands. And what is this? A sandblasted glass ultrasonic aromatherapy diffuser silently diffuses scented oil into the air. Well, that's, I don't know. Do you want scented oil in the air? Don't know if that's a good idea for your lungs. Let's see. What is this? Here's a, uses powerful LED lights to reduce and prevent wrinkles. I'm having a hard time seeing that. I don't know why they couldn't make the print a little darker. You know, it's a white background. Print that was a little bit bolder and easier to read would be nice. But, reduces and prevents wrinkles and creases in the lips. Wow. Wonder if that works. I mean, aren't lips supposed to have some wrinkles and creases in them? I don't think I've ever seen anyone with lips that did not have wrinkles and creases. Let's see. Here's a towel warmer. That's pretty neat. A warm towel is pretty cool, I guess. Now, how could that be so? If it's warm, it can't be cool. And vice versa. Here's a device that fights the effects of brightness and dry eye syndrome. With dry eye therapy mask. Okay. So out of everything I see here, if I was going to choose something for her, it says gifts for her right there. If I was going to choose something here for her, I don't think it would be any of this stuff. Certainly not that. But I would get this rose. Next page. A professional facial rejuvenator. And here is a mask, a light therapy mask. I guess it takes the wrinkles out of your face. Here's a cozy foot massager. Here's a neck and shoulder massager. And a adjustable vanity mirror. Here's a foot bath. Okay. They call it a foot and leg spa. Here's a automatic cordless hair curler right here. And some heated socks that use batteries. And here's a heated wearable blanket right here. So the socks have some pretty heavy soles on the bottom. So I don't think they would be very practical to wear inside your boots while you're ice fishing. So to tell you the truth, I wouldn't buy any of this stuff, I don't think. But if I had to buy something, I would buy maybe the facial rejuvenator, because it's small and I don't even really know what the benefit would be, but let's give the gadget a try. Okay. Here's a device for getting rid of stubborn facial hair. Here is a device, another hair removal device. She's using it on her shin. Here is a double chin reducing massager. Here is a cellulite remover. Over here is a callus vacuum. It exfoliates the dry skin of the callus and it vacuums it up. It's kind of gross. Here's a professional laser facial hair remover. Here's some more socks, I think, that you put lotion in and softens your feet. Here's an electric underarm toner. And a under eye rejuvenator. And guess what? Most of this stuff uses batteries. Okay. So, once again, what would be the most useful thing? I don't think I have any cellulite. At least, I don't think so. So, I don't need that. Double chin. I don't have a double chin yet. I have to admit, though, the older I get, you know, that skin underneath my chin is not quite as tight as it once was. I just don't know. So it's kind of a toss-up. So we're just gonna go by the way it looks. And this is this thing here has some color to it, and it looks neat. So let's choose that. There's soothing massage gloves, battery operated. I guess they massage your fingers. Here is a heated compression leg wraps. It rejuvenates your legs, I guess. And hip therapy pain reliever to get rid of the pain. So everything there's electric. Here's a acupressure pain relief massage pen. Hot and cold. The pain relieving socks. Here's a foot massager and a pain relieving cervical pain relieving device, I guess, when you have a neck pain. And another foot massager. Okay. I think if I was going to use anything here, I guess it would be a foot massager. Everything seems to be about relieving pain. You know, I thought Sharper Image had a lot of cool stuff in it, but this is, what is this? This is the geriatric version of Sharper Image. I mean, I can say that because, you know, I'm older. I can get away with that, but it's just everything about it so far seems to be mostly about relieving pain. Here's a physiotherapy massager. And here's a wrist therapy wrap for wrist pain, like from like carpal tunnel syndrome. Here's a hand compression massager. And here's a foot massager that has the electrical pulses, and it's also heated. I guess it might work well for foot pain, perhaps. Here's a LED hand pain relief mitten. And a cordless decompression massage belt helps alleviate pain and stiffness down there in your lower back. And here's a heated neck therapy device. I currently know somebody that broke their hand, and it's healing back up, but the person is having a lot of pain in their hand. So here's two hand, here's a hand pain relieving mitten. So I'm going to check into that. I may actually buy that for this person. Here's some holiday decor. Some wreaths. Yep. And some garland. Little plastic candles. Here's a wreath to go around a mailbox. And some flameless hanging snowflake candles. And LED, LED globes. Let me give you a better look at those. Yeah, those are pretty. Here's a animated talking snowman talking snowman. He has a built-in projector. Here's a LED snowman pillow set. I'll give you a good look at those too. I guess everything has to have LEDs in it. What is that? The animated talking snowman is a fun and whimsical addition to any holiday decor. This charming character talks, jokes, and even sings holiday tunes, thanks to a built-in projector and speaker. Just plug it in and he provides 45 minutes of Yuletide cheer. Wow. How can you not? How can you not get that? How can you not get that? I think I actually want that. But then again, I'm just a big kid. I'm just a big kid at heart. Here's some heated jackets. That's pretty cool. Some heated gloves. Here's a rechargeable hand warmer. And a wireless rechargeable glove liners to put into your gloves. All that stuff's very useful if you spend any time outdoors, in cold weather areas, especially Wisconsin. Here is some heated insoles for your boots and heated slippers. That's exactly what you need when you're, sitting around at night in the hunting lodge, Heated socks and heated long johns. So all that looks pretty cool. The rechargeable hand warmer, kind of tweaks my interest. Let me give you a good look at that. Because they don't look to be very big. And if you had one in each pocket, you know, just stick your hands in your coat pocket, stay warm. I think that looks pretty neat. Here is a, looks like an arcade game. It's like $3,000, so yeah, it's Pac-Man. It's a arcade style game. Here's a hovering curling set, you know, where you slide these disc down the track, try to stop it on the bullseye. Here's a pocket video drone. So that's a drone. Here's a portable drive-in movie theater. So you take that out, hang up a sheet outside, and project a movie onto the sheet. I guess that would be pretty cool if you're having a big camp out somewhere and you got a bunch of people. Here is a electronic lighted chess set. Here is a jellyfish aquarium. Obviously they're not real jellyfish. Portable badminton with LED birdies. I guess so that you can play at night in the evening. I guess that could be useful. In a 3D drawing pen. I guess it melts plastic, and you just kind of layer it and build up some kind of sculpted artwork. I've never been too crazy about those. I do like drones. I do like chess. I don't think I would like chess on a gimmicky board, though. And I think I would get bored playing Pac-Man, so I'm going to go with a drone. Santa's toy shop. Here's that virtual Pong game that was at the front of the catalog. Here's an infrared laser tag set. Here's a microscope for curious minds. Here's a walkie-talkie spy robot. Glow-in-the-dark floating target games. Here's a terrain walker kit where you can build basically a walking robot. It's got a bunch of examples. All that stuff looks like it's fresh out of Boston Dynamics Labs. Have you seen any of those robots that Boston Dynamics is working on? Look up some of the YouTube videos on Boston Dynamics. That stuff's creepy. And what's that? Radio control bumper cars. And I guess if you hit someone's car just right, their little driver flies out of the car. Huh. I'm going to get the microscope. Looking at stuff under a microscope would be far. That kind of entertainment would be far lasting. Much more than any of the other stuff. You could get that microscope and, you know, you could use that all your life. Here is some transforming vehicles that transform from a vehicle into a big robot. Here's a Wild West shooting set where you can shoot the bottles and stuff off of the log. A planetarium projector. Project the night sky onto your ceiling. An electronic boxing bag. So you let your kid train to be the next UFC star champion. Here's a glow-in-the-dark nano, that means really, really, really small, RC helicopter. That thing is tiny. Here's some kind of electronic drum set. And stranger creature catcher. Test your monster hunting skills with a stranger creature catcher. The blaster projects colorful monsters onto your walls and ceiling. And virtual archery challenge. Okay, so there's a bow. And you put your phone in the little bracket. And you pull the string back and let it go, but there's no arrows involved. But you can hit stuff on your screen. Now that looks fun. That looks fun. So I think I was wanting the bag, the kicking bag, so that I could train for my next UFC fight. But I think I'm going to go with the virtual archery bow. Okay, what do we have? A boardless skateboard. So you got these rings that rotate, and there's a platform in there for your shoes to rest on. But there's no board. I don't know why they call it a skateboard. Because a skateboard has 8 wheels, and this is just 2, and there's no board. I think these people need to rename this. If you got an idea for what they can call this, let us know in the comments. It's definitely not a skateboard. Foot tires or foot rings or something, but not skateboard. Here is a giant piano mat that you can walk around on and play some music. Here's a very small drone. Here's a glow-in-the-dark target popper. Space blasters shooting game. Interactive talking globe. And Shadow Fighter. So I guess it projects a shadow onto the wall. And I'm not sure what you're going to do. I guess you're going to use your shadow to kick around at the other shadow, I guess. So I think I'm going to get, and you probably guessed it, the drone. And as much as I hate to, I think we're going to end it right here. We're gonna put a bookmark in it, and I'm gonna make a part two. But it's pretty late. It's pretty late at night. It's after 10 o'clock p.m. It's been a long day. I'm pretty tired. And many of you are probably asleep by now, so. But if you stuck it out and you watched all the way to the end, you can let me know in the comments by using the phrase, "Everything should not need batteries. Everything shouldn't need batteries." Because we live in this world where you gotta have batteries for everything. Anyhow, I hope you liked this video. I was hoping to stretch it out to an even 1 hour. I've got about a minute left if I'm going to make this video an hour. So, what can I do to stretch this out? I guess I can draw something. I'm not sure what. Maybe a sleigh. I don't know if this makes a... It's a terrible sleigh. Not much of a sleigh. Sleigh. Whatever. It did the job. Looks like we made it to an hour, so. Anyhow. We'll see you next time. If you want to see the rest of this catalog, please let me know in the comments. I appreciate each one of you. I appreciate you watching. I certainly appreciate my patrons over on Patreon. So, until next time, take care.